I have been looking forward to this for quite some time. I think this example of Powered by Powercast perfectly illustrates why you might want or need RF wireless technology in your product. This is a Kookaburra Smart Cricket Ball. Nothing special on the outside, looks like a normal cricket ball, acts like a normal cricket ball. However, on the inside, there's so much great technology: accelerometer, speedometer, Bluetooth radio, Powercaster, power harvester chips. It's got a little brain and a tiny rechargeable battery. You see, in cricket, in order to get the data on the spin rate and the bounce, you have to set up cameras that record the moment that it comes off the bowler's hands, and you can start the data there, which means different sized bowlers have to be, it has to be adjusted for them, and it has to be set up, and it just wasn't a great way to get real-time data into the hands of the people that need it, you know, the audience, the broadcasters, and everything like that. So SportCore thought, hey, what if we put the electronics inside the ball and it talked to something that gave us everything we needed to know during the game? When SportCore came to us to try to solve a problem that plagued so many other manufacturers of sporting equipment, we had the perfect team to do it. We had the expertise to make the circuit boards with all the components, and we had the RF wireless and Bluetooth expertise to keep the battery charged so they'd keep the sensors supplying the necessary data even after being bashed with the bat time and time again. Here's the coolest part about this ball. There is nothing weird going on the outside. Everything is stuffed perfectly in the center, so this acts and reacts just like a normal ball, because you don't have a port coming out where you have to charge it, or you don't have to have a flap to get the electronics out to get the data out. This is made and sewn up just like a regular cricket ball and has been tested and acts exactly like another cricket ball because you don't have anything coming off the side in order to get power to it. Now, how do you get power to it? That's the cool thing about it. Every night before a match, you have a base and you just rest it on the base. And it has a little cover. What happens is the radio waves permeate the ball. They go into the power harvester chip that's in the middle of the ball, turns the radio waves into usable DC power, charges up the battery enough for, you know, how long cricket games can go. During the game, it's throwing out all this data perfectly from all the sensors inside the ball. At the end of the game, pop it back on the thing and it charges. I don't see any other way that you could do this without wireless charging. I mean, to have all that stuff stuffed inside here, giving you that data, imagine what you can get if it was a baseball, if it was a lacrosse ball, if it was a hockey puck. I mean, anything really. And that's what's so exciting, are the many uses that we're finding for RF wireless power. If you like Powered by Powercast, please subscribe. You'll get notified when we do more of these. And you can check out all the other ones we've already done.